Hello class, today we are going to discuss Joseph Andrews by Henry Fielding. Before beginning with a detailed analysis of the novel, let us first cover the summary of the novel. The full title of the novel is The History of the Adventures of Joseph Andrews and His Friend Mr. Abraham Adams. Written in the imitation of The Manner of Cervantes, author of Don Quixote. This novel was published by Fielding in February 1742. As I told you earlier that in 1740s we see a rise in the novels. So this novel, Joseph Andrews, is a part of that tradition of the rise of the novel. This novel is basically a parody. It has a lot of comical elements, but it also has some episodes of seriousness. So it is a mixture of comedy and seriousness. Fielding described his novel as a comic epic in prose. The novel was written by Fielding with the intention of writing a travesty, but it is considered the first English novel that provides the function of the aesthetic. So in this lecture, you will not only study about the summary and critical analysis of Joseph Andrews, but you will also understand the novel as a genre. You will get to know the various elements that make up a novel, and how a novel differs from other literary genres such as a poem or a short story or drama. So if we talk about novel as a genre, so novel as a genre is an extended narrative and it is quite distinct from a short story. A novel is described as a long narrative in literary prose. If we trace the history of novel, then we can go back to the 14th century. European oral culture is replete with a lot of storytelling. So storytelling has been a part of the European culture. So the history of novels storytelling can be traced back to the medieval romances, an earlier classical tradition of oral storytelling. And there was also a tradition of novella. Novella were shorter novels, and novella basically means a little new thing. And if we talk about the various types of novels, then novels have different varieties. You can have an epistolary novel. Epistolary novel is written in the form of letters. You can have a picaresque novel. In picaresque novel, we have an adventurer like Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe. This novel that you are studying also comes under picaresque because it is about Joseph Andrews' adventures with his friend Abraham Adams. And there are also realistic novels too. Realistic novels were written more in modern and postmodern age, such as Mrs. Dalloway by Virginia Woolf. So they deal with the harsh reality of life. So novel have very various types too. So now if you talk about the ingredients of a novel, then novel has a particular structure. It consists of a theme, a storyline, plot, characters, and there is also a world of make-believe, because at the end of the day it is a fiction. Now talking about the theme of a novel, what are the themes that are discussed on a novel? A novel is a mirror to the contemporary society, the current period in which it is written. So the novel shows as its theme the prejudices of the society or the time in which it is written, the joys, frivolities, follies and manners of the contemporary society. Henry Fielding along with Samuel Richardson are two great names in the history of English literature in the novel genre. They are the great names who contributed to the rise of the novel in the mid-18th century. Fielding's novels are considered very relevant in the history of the contemporary storytelling in the novel genre, because the characters of the characters in the novels by Fielding, they control the storytelling. Their story is not controlled by other aspects of the society or the external aspects. They are the people who control the plot of the novel. So Fielding's novels hold a very important place in the contemporary genre of novel writing. So if we talk about the novels of the 18th and 19th century, then they dominantly come under the genre of the realistic novels, because they were an extension of the real conditions of the society. So we have basically three names at the stalwarts of the English novel writing tradition: Daniel Defoe, Samuel Richardson, and Henry Fielding. So this novel by Joseph Andrews, it is written in the tradition of imitation of Miguel de Cervantes, the author of Don Quixote. Now coming to the background of the novel, Joseph Andrews was a great success and it was widely read by the people of the 18th century. So for people, the novel... For people of that age, this novel Joseph Andrews, it provided an idyllic society, an idyllic world in which there is satire, there is farce, and along with it, there is also a kind of somber atmosphere. So it was a mixture of comedy and somber attitude of the characters, which is considered as an idyllic world by the readers. There should be a little bit comedy and there should also be a little bit seriousness. After Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe and Moll Flanders and Samuel Richardson's Pamela, the writings of Fielding brought in a kind of comical atmosphere in the novel genre. So Joseph Andrews was the beginning of the era of parody in the novels. Earlier, they were mainly focusing on the society or the picaresque or the adventures. But Joseph Andrews brought in the tradition of parody in the novel genre. So the writing style of Henry Fielding was very much in contrast with the earlier romantic ideal writings that we had in the classic narratives of prose, such as like the fairy tales, winged horses, castles, and giants, and all the fantastical descriptions that we had, like in Spenser's Fairy Queen. They were very like fantastical elements. But in writings of Henry Fielding, and with the rise of the novel tradition as a genre, we see that the writing style became more realistic. Now the writing was more focused on realism and on parodying the contemporary scene rather than out of the world descriptions of characters. So the main tradition that Joseph Andrews follows is the comic romance. But this novel is not just focused on comedy and romance. It has also integral elements of wit and seriousness and morality. The novel has a preface and it consists of four books, and these four books comprise 64 chapters. And the chapters are written in a mock epic style, because the mock epic style was very famous during the mid 18th century. So both the poems we studied in The Rape of the Lock, it was a mock epic poem by Alexander Pope. Similarly, this is a mock epic novel by Henry Fielding in the Augustan Age. So in the preface of the novel Joseph Andrews, we see that Fielding tries to explain the new genre, the novel itself. So Fielding compares and contrasts in preface how novel as a genre is different and similar to other literary forms, and how it is related to the classical literary forms that are described by great philosophers such as Aristotle. So, in the preface, Fielding describes how his novel differs from other literary genres such as epic romances or the drama or the burlesque or any other literary form. How novel differs from other literary forms. Now, in preface, Fielding describes that the fact that he is writing a comic epic in prose, it does not mean that it is buffoonery or it is filled with ridiculousness. And also, he describes that it is not an epic in verse either. It is a comic epic, but it is in prose. And it is a comic epic, but it is not entire buffoonery. So, in this novel, Fielding basically infused two literary genres. So it is a comic epic. It has the elements of an epic, but it is not tragic. It has comical elements, and it is in prose. It is not in poetic form. So it has elements of drama, but without being in a poetic form. And one more thing, Fielding states in the preface that he is writing based on a realistic tradition. He will not use the fables of the past, but will base his narrative on the everyday life or everyday realistic life of the characters. So this was basically a general background of the age of the novel and how Fielding has a great name in novel and Joseph Andrews is very important in the novel tradition. So this is the background, and now we are going to cover the summary and list of characters in the novel. Now, coming to the summary and the list of characters of Joseph Andrews by Fielding. So, the entire story is based on the character Joseph Andrews, and Joseph Andrews is the supposed brother of the chaste heroine of Samuel Richardson's novel Pamela. So, he is considered the brother of Pamela. So, this is written in a parody tradition of Samuel Richardson's Pamela. So, in this novel, we see there is a lady character, Lady Booby. And Lady Booby makes immoral advances towards Joseph. Joseph is a servant in the house of Lady Booby. And Lady Booby constantly makes immoral advances towards Joseph. So, Lady Booby is very rich. And so a class contrast is shown in between Lady Booby and Joseph Andrews, where Lady Booby is shown behaving very immorally towards Joseph. But Joseph does not have any interest in pursuing Lady Booby because he is in love with his childhood friend Fanny. So he does not give in to the immoral advances of Lady Booby. As a result, Joseph is forced to leave his job and the house of Lady Booby, and he is expelled from the job, and he is forced to leave, and he goes on a picaresque venture. So he journeys, and we see during his journey he meets many new experiences. It is during this journey only that Joseph meets Parson Adams. Parson Adams perform a very crucial role in the life of Joseph Andrews because he becomes a moral guide of Joseph throughout his journey. He is an erudite person, but he is eccentric too. So during his journey, Joseph meets a number of experiences, and as the journey moves on, Joseph meets Fanny, and both of them also meet Parson Adams, and they continue their journey toward the parish of Parish Adams. So Abraham Adams tried to perform the marriage ceremony of Joseph Andrews and Fanny, but both Lady Booby and Pamela Andrews, they try to obstruct the marriage of Joseph Andrews and Fanny because Fanny has an unknown parentage, and people think that Joseph is brother of Fanny, because it is considered that Fanny is also daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Andrews. So all these things creates confusion, and Joseph and Fanny find it impossible to marry. So when Mr. and Mrs. Andrews intervene, a shocking revelation comes that in fact Fanny is the real daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Andrews, and she was stolen by a gypsy in her childhood. And in fact, Joseph Andrews is not the real son of Mr. and Mrs. Andrews, and his real father is Mr. Wilson. So finally, at the end of the novel, the two lovers, Joseph and Fanny, they get married. So this was the basic summary of the novel, and now coming to the major characters, we first of all have Parson Abraham Adams. Parson Abraham Adams is an erudite scholar. He is a man of good sense, but he is ignorant of the ways of the changing world, how the world is changing. And Mr. Adams has a great role in being a moral and spiritual guide of Joseph Andrews, and he is the one who asked Joseph Andrews to follow the rules of Christianity and be chaste. And now we have the main character, Joseph Andrews. He is a 21-year-old boy who is musical, virtuous, and he could retain his purity and chastity because he was on the path of Christianity on the suggestion of Mr. Adams, who asked him to remain virtuous and chaste. And this is the reason he does not give in to the advances of Lady Booby. Next, we have Fanny Goodwill. Fanny Goodwill is the real child of Mr. and Mrs. Andrews, and she was stolen in childhood by a gypsy. And she is the real sister of Pamela, and she is a modest lady. Now we have Sir Thomas Booby. Sir Thomas Booby was the husband of Lady Booby, but he died in the early stages of the novel. So basically, Lady Booby was a widow. Now next we have Lady Booby. Lady Booby is wife of late Sir Thomas Booby, and she thinks that world is meant for pleasure. She does not have any concern for morality and religion, and Joseph works as a servant to Lady Booby, and she tries to seduce him, but she fails. And when Lady Booby fails to seduce Joseph Andrews, she dismisses Joseph from the service. Another character we have is Mrs. Slipslop. Mrs. Slipslop is a paid companion to Lady Booby. Pamela Andrews is thought to be the sister of Joseph, and Joseph looks on Pamela as an epitome of chastity. Another character we have is Peter Pounce. Peter Pounce is a steward to Lady Booby. And another character we have is Mr. Wilson. Mr. Wilson is the real father of Joseph Andrews. Next character we have is Squire Booby. Squire Booby is the nephew of Lady Booby, and he is the husband of Pamela. Next we have Beau Dedapper. He is typical dandy of late 17th and early 18th century, and he is a person known for fashionable ways and manners. Beau Dedapper is sent by Lady Booby to persuade Fanny and to charm and attract Fanny, but he remains unsuccessful at his attempts. Now coming to the novel, as I earlier told you, the novel is divided into four books, and each book is subdivided into chapters. So in book one, we basically have an introduction of the characters of the novel, like Parson Adams, Mrs. Slipslop, Lady Booby. So we have basic introduction of characters in book one. So Fielding sets the stage of the novel with book one by giving a basic introduction of the characters. It is in book one only that Fielding makes it clear that the novel is based on a mock epic style. So we come in the middle of the action, or in medias res, in chapter four. So in this chapter, we see that Joseph is introduced in the genteel, sophisticated, aesthetic society and life of London, and he develops a taste for art, music. He becomes a connoisseur of great taste. So we see that Joseph is under the tutelage of Sir Thomas Booby, and Sir Thomas Booby gives him the knowledge of the taste of art, the taste of music, and how to behave in the genteel life of London. So, but on the opposite end, we don't see such a contribution from Lady Booby. Lady Booby is more interested in immoral behavior towards Joseph, and she is sexually attracted towards Joseph, who is of the age of her son. So in the following chapters, we see the attempts of Lady Booby to seduce Joseph, and this leads to social discussions and gossip in the society, and ultimately it leads to the escape of Joseph. So in chapter 13, we see Joseph has managed to escape the gossip of the city, and this comes as a blessing in disguise for Joseph. Actually, he is away from the malice of Lady Booby and the society, the gossiping society, and he is all set for new adventures in his life. And the adventure of Joseph is Fielding's way of showing the vices and virtues of life. And we see this contrast in Joseph's meeting with both the robbers and the priest. So Joseph meets robbers on the one hand and priest on the other hand, that is Parson Adams. So both these instances, they are structured to portray the sharp contrasts of life. So on one hand, we have the immoral characters like Lady Booby and the robbers. And on the other hand, we have Parson Adams, who is epitome of positivity, virtues and morality in this world of corruption.